What up, guys? We finally have a day two, this time in the 15K. It's like a $2,000 buy-in. Has about 120 runners, made day two. There will also be late reg available next, like tomorrow, so there's still gonna be a couple more guys in there, but looking really good right now. Back, that's the fucking chip leader. 15K starting, I had exactly 100,000 actually. So yeah, pretty good one. It's like a slow tournament, or like fairly slow, so plays pretty well. It feels fucking great. I mean, we fought so hard, had a lot of battles, didn't really get anything done, really. Like, started out the trip, like bubbling the first event and then the next, like 8 events or like 8 buy-ins for everything pretty much. I just busted. So yeah, pretty excited about it now. Heading back to the hotel room, it's like 1:30 a.m. here. Wasn't even that long of a day, man. Like, live poker is just so much fun, cool people. Like, I fucking love Asia, honestly. When I play in the King's Casino, most people are like a bit grumpy or they don't talk much, but here everybody is excited to gamble. The tables are fun, much better environment to gamble. Great position overall. Have to get that Macau flag tomorrow. I mean, super likely. Tournament is really, really soft. I'm feeling much better now, like, a bit more focused while playing. It's just nice to, like, get the folds when you triple barrel bluffs, get called when you overbet for obviously only value in the spot and stuff. So yeah, see you guys tomorrow and hope we keep on running good. Alright, first break on day two. Dom and some other guys are playing the Super Roller Bowl now. I am playing the day two. Had 100k starting. Now, like, for day two, already up to 175,000. Was a pretty sick start. Like, I'm by far the chip leader now. With, like, I think 50 left. I assume there's, like, only 10, 12, maybe 9 paid. Like, not that much. First place, like, $40,000. That's a nice little side event, really soft. Sadly, just got a table with, like, there's, like, 3 German racks in there, and 2 of them are on my table now, which isn't ideal. But at least we have some fun table talk going on. Besides that, yeah, it's just going really, really smoothly. Like, first hand of the day, I get dealt aces. We're like 5-handed, I open, big blind defense. Flop comes down, king 3-3. And button calls as well. I bet like 40%, button calls. Big blind raises 3x. I call, button folds, and then he jams turn, I snap, and he has king 10. Yeah, pretty nice spot. The other hand was also pretty fun. Like, I flat pocket eights in the middle position versus like UGG plus 1 open. Big blind calls, flop comes down, check 10-8 with a flush draw. So I flop bottom set. It's check to me. I decided to bet a third, which is like the correct sizing in that spot because it's a really good board for my range. I think in live poker I should just generally size up a bit because nobody's going to abuse me for that. So, or exploit me. So yeah, I should have bet a bit bigger, but it doesn't really matter. So I bet a third. Big blind folds, UGG calls. Turn brings another 8. Which is pretty funny because I was looking at the guy and seeing like how, the way, like how he checks it, and I was thinking, okay, an 8 on the turn would be pretty sick, and boom, there's the 8. So yeah, quads, easy life. He checks it again, I fire like 80%, he calls, and then river is the flush draw, like comes up on the river with like a low card, so we have check 10, 8, 8 low card with the flush arriving on the river. He checks it again, I think about it, jam for like 150% pot. He goes into the tank for a bit and then makes the call with ace 10 with the ace that blocks the flush draw. Yeah, I take it. So now we have all the chips and hopefully things will work out because 40 grand would be nice. So as you saw, guys, we made it down to the final two tables. 18 people left. I'm probably like top 3 in chips. Oh, there's Mike in the mix. You wanna join the vlog?
Say what?
What are you doing, buddy?
You alright?
What are you playing?
I'm playing a satellite for the main event.
Oh.
I bought in for more than one main event seat so far, and I've not won a seat yet, so.
That's a nice strategy usually. It doesn't sometimes work out well, but it's a strat.
How many left in yours? Like,
there's like 18 left. I'm like, have a top 3 stack, I think. I'm guessing, maybe like top 5. So yeah, 3 more people need to be knocked out. It's been going pretty damn well. I know, like, this day started, I got in with aces versus like king 10 and king 3-3. Then yeah, like, worked my way up with like lots of raises and stuff to 175,000. So started day with 100k, obviously. Besides that, I dropped down to the 125k again. He recorded against a fellow German, and he had it. So I was down to like 120k. Now I made the comeback. I almost have 200,000 now. I know some interesting hands. Like this modern is really aggressive, right? I'm aggressive on the button. He threw at me a lot, so I decided to limp 7-4 suited on the button. He checked. He completed. Big blind checked. Flop comes down. Queen 7-3 with a flush draw. I check it. Like everybody checks it. Turn is another 7. Offsuit. He leads. Like small man needs 80%. I call. River is the ace of diamonds, so flush draw breaks. And he bets like close to pot. I snap and he just mucks it. And that was a good hand. And then now just putting on some pressure, like with 3 of the money. I think, like I'm actually the chip lead on my table. On the other table, there's like 2 or 3 stacks, I think, that are bigger than me. But it's a good spot to apply a lot of pressure. Still a bunch of fish left. Like it's a pretty soft tournament at this point. There might be some records that I don't know. There's only one German left that I didn't know who's pretty solid. So yeah, we'll keep you guys updated. Quick break now. It's been a long day already. And I'm gonna play the main after that. So yeah, we're in the absolute stone bubble right now. I'm one of the biggest decks on my table. And I just raised call the jam with pocket nines for 15 blinds. I opened like the cutoff big blind snap re-jam, so I think he's gonna have ace king, but he doesn't show yet because there's still a hand on the other table. It's been a stone bubble. Just hoping for the fucking best right now. We won the stone bubble, 16 people left, 15 paid, $4,000 min cash, 60k up top once again. He turns over ace queen, flop brings the 9 already.
Oh!
No club, no club.
No club.
No club. Yes!
Oh!
Yes, unlucky.
Unlucky.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Good game, good game. Guys, we just made the final table. So there's like 9 people left. I lost a huge pot before I dove with check 4 of hearts against deuces on 6-3 deuces, 2 hearts, and didn't get there. So now I have 15 blinds, let's hope for the best. Made the final table, guys, with like 15 BB after losing a pick pot and got a nice double up with aces suited versus queens. Always an ace, man, you can believe it. After that, you know, got some steals through. Blinds just go up after break, so I only have 30 big blinds, but I'm second in chips with that. Like, there's a girl to my right, she has like 5 blinds now, there's another guy with like 10 or 12 blinds. So right now for me, I will try to get a ladder or two. Obviously we'll still like rejam maybe, or like 3-bet and flat some, but I have to be careful now. Yeah, but I'm second in chips, pretty good. 30 big blinds is not that much, obviously. Like, tournament was well structured, but now because of like the long bubble, I think it's pretty quick, so yeah. Next double up is really, really important, and then we could seriously have a shot at 62,000. Alright guys, that's it. Ladded up nicely to third place. I had actually a good shot at the win in between, but finally lost 2 big hands in the end. Cut off open jammed 7 blinds, I snap called the big blind with A7 off. He had A9 suited. Just like an easy call there, so I was down to about 20 blinds. Blinded down a bit, then the other guy busted, we were 3-handed, and what I did is woke up with ace 8 suited for 15 blinds and button. One guy had a shit ton of chips, the other girl had like a bit more than I had, like around 50% more, yeah, it was quite a bit actually. And I had 15 blinds and button, and decided to raise call instead of open jamming. The reason for that is just because the small blind was really aggressive, and like he re-jammed every open pretty much. So I want to induce like jams from 8-9 suited, 10-8, ace deuce, shit like that. So I opened, he rejammed, I called, he had queen check offsuit and hit the check on the flop and the river. So I didn't win that one, but we finished in third place for like 220,000 Macau dollars. That's what this shit looks like. Get like this fucking stack of money that I have to put into some deposit box now. Pretty annoying, but hey, whatever. It's worth like 27,000 US dollars, which is still pretty good, right? We have a profitable trip locked up, which is awesome. And yeah, So that's sweet. I have to figure out what to do next. I'm fucking hungry. It's 1 a.m. and I've been grinding till since 12 p.m. It's been like a 13-hour session. Good cash in the end. Pretty happy with it overall. I mean, third place. At the South Find Table, I was like, okay, I take third place. You chop it. And it actually happened, so I'm not mad at all. Tomorrow is the main, so more vlogging coming up. Let's get another deep run.